Kali is not here, and the other guy. You guys come forward. I want you guys to come. Just come to the front. I want you to get on the altar there. Get up there, climb up, and so I don't know. I need Judah. Can you take some pictures while your mother is doing this? To do the recording there. That's a phone there with you. Greg and Chelsea and Cheryl, can you guys come and stand behind them, please? It's so wonderful to see. I know, okay, you guys are keeping, are you taking 3 pictures? Okay, the tree, all right. I want you guys to come a little bit forward. You guys come forward. These are the destinies that we're going to be releasing into the world, and we believe that today God is going to do, your future is already so colorful and bright. It's going to be an awesome time. Before we present the things, Greg, you have something to say to your youth? Right.
Can't believe you guys have grown up that quickly. Especially courage was this one. But you guys are doing awesome. And this year has been very difficult for everybody and a big change for everybody, and you guys still made it. And in your future endeavors, there's something different about being a Christian, having God in your heart, because God paves the way for excellence. He paves the way for blessings in your lives. And whatever you go, if you're going to be studying, working, whatever you're going to be doing, if you rely on God and walk His ways, today in the education system and studying further, it is more and more difficult to follow God's ways. It is up to you personally to go and walk with God. And He will make your path straight, and He will make you shine above all other students. And whichever way you go, when you guys one day find your families, when you one day go into your vacations, everything, if you follow God, it's the best way to go. And sometimes it doesn't feel like that. People are going to come down on you. They're going to think, oh, who's this guy trying to be better than us? Or this girl trying to be better than us? But you must know that you are doing it for God. And I hope that is in your hearts. Only you can make that personal choice. So I believe God is going to bless you richly as you move forward in your lives. And it is His plan for every one of us to just be uplifted and to move forward and just to be a light on that hill for Him. So let's quickly pray. Father, we just thank You that these young people are standing in Your house in front of Your people, just being honored for their dedication in going to school. Father, we know so many people have left school and so many people who do not endeavor just to further their knowledge. And Father, even though there's nothing wrong with that, Father, we just thank You for these young people who are planning to just better themselves and their lives. And we just give them honor today in Your name that they have graduated and that they're just with us today in this church. And Father, we just pray that You pour out Your blessings, Your love, Your spirit upon them, and that they just be that salt of this world, this beacon, this light on this hill, that they will just stand out and just bring Your name to the generation. Ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
I cheated. I got a cheat sheet. I know how well my memory works. I just want to remind you of everything that your parents have taught you and everything they did, how you got grounded, how you got in trouble. I just want you to know that Mom and Dad aren't going to be there to ground you, to look after you, to make you do what's right. And now it's your choice. And we just want you to get that in your head after all the years that you've been brought up, that they tried to do their best. And the thing is God wants you to use their platform that they left off on so you guys can go higher and you can do better. And whatever your parents might have made a mistake with or you didn't think was right, it's up to you guys to change it into something better. I also want you to remember that you guys are going to affect our world one way or the other. It could be good, it could be bad, whatever. But you guys are the next generation that's going to change things, whether voting, whether in a department, whether in a business. It's up to you guys to change. And it's up to you guys to tell people about Jesus. I know you know that from before, but now you're on your own and you guys represent Jesus. And it's up to you guys to be the best you can be. You know how sometimes when you're brought up, you can lie, you can hide things from people, you can do things and they won't catch up. But the problem is God sees. And that is so much bigger than what your parents see. And God's looking at your heart and he's watching it and he says, I want all of it. I want your whole heart, not just a part of it. And I don't want you to compromise and slide with the other kids when you're on your own, because you're not going to have mom and dad say, well, do you think that's a good choice? Was it, you know, should you be mean to that person? No, you shouldn't do that. You guys are of age to make those choices. And I just pray that God will give you wisdom, discernment, and understanding that as you make those changes, it will change the world. And you know, right when you guys go to school, and if you're not going right away, but when you do, you guys can transform the atmosphere in your classrooms by just your presence and speaking life into people without even mentioning Jesus' name. So I want you guys to remember everything you've learned, things that you didn't like and agree with, well, throw them out, and you guys do better. Don't go back and say, well, mom and dad did this, and now I can't stop. No, it's up to you guys to change that. And you guys are going to be the best, the greatest, because you got God to help you. And there's going to be people in your classes that are going to fall apart. They're going to be lost. They're going to be depressed. And you guys have the answer to encourage them. Keep your eyes and your heart open, because God might say, I want you to talk to that person. I want you to tell that person, have a great day. Maybe that's what they need for the day. Don't forget, God has placed in you guys a huge bucket of gold. And he wants you to give it away. Don't keep it. Give it away.
Amen. And then we're going to pray. Does anybody have anything to say to the kids? Or we'll pray for them. Sister Melody, would you have a comment stand proxy for your granddaughter or anyone of you? For Callie, please. We're going to just pray for the kids and then do this. I want you to just stretch forth your hands. Kids, I want you to do this. I want you to just dip your hands dip your hands in the letter. Yeah. Go and put it in your. You know, put your hands in your forehead. Just put your hands in your forehead as we pray. As we pray for you, you just put your hands in your forehead. As a church, just stretch out your hands towards the children and just begin to this wonderful man and woman, that their destiny will not be truncated by the enemy, that this once they shall bear fruit in their season, that their season shall not be a minute late, will not be a minute too early, that you will not be numbered among the statistics of your generation. You shall be a man and woman to be sought after. You'll be an individual that will stand out in the name of Jesus. Your destiny will not be overshadowed by any tragedy in the name of Jesus. You shall not be numbered among the mediocres of your generation. You shall be numbered among the voice of change and hope in your generation in the name of Jesus. The purpose of God for your life, as you stand with us this day, from this ground, we release you into the world to effect change that will bring glory to God and glory to your family. Your family shall not weep over you. You will not fail because the Lord our God will lift you up above and beyond. You shall not be numbered among the failures of your generation. Whatever you lay your hand to do shall prosper. The favor of the Lord shall be upon your forehead. Where your parents failed, you shall succeed in the name of Jesus. Where your parents experienced disappointment, their failure marked the beginning of excellency for you in the name of Jesus. In your family, you shall be a name to be reckoned with. In your generation, you shall be men and women to be reckoned with in the name of Jesus. We call upon the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God who called those things that are not as though they are. We decree and declare that your future is colorful and they are bright in the name of Jesus. Everything that the enemy, any pit that has already been dug for you that is invincible, you shall escape every trap of the enemy in the name of Jesus. Where your parents were victims at this age, you shall not in the name of Jesus. Whatever stories of woes and misery that your parents experienced at this age in their life, you shall not partake in it in the name of Jesus. Whatever is prevalent in your family negatively, from today we decree in the name of Jesus that you shall not. We pray that the grace of exemption that is present in this house exempts you from tragedy, exempts you from failure, exempts you from untimely death in the name of Jesus. Terminal disease and illnesses shall not be mentioned in your generation. The Lord shall cause you to be a man and woman of excellence in the name of Jesus. We say we release you into your generation, into the world, to be a voice and to be a light. May the hand of the Lord rest upon you. May the Lord cause men to be favorably disposed unto you. As you turn to leave this town and to go into school or into your workplace, the Spirit of God will go with you. He will cause men to greet you and to give to you. You shall never be stranded in life in the name of Jesus. Because of you, your parents will not become destitute. You will not beg. You will not be influenced. Any trap of illegal lifestyle and falsehood and drug addiction, prostitution, perversion of any kind, you shall escape from it in the name of Jesus. Your parents shall not lose sleep over you in the name of Jesus. We pray that the glory of God will go with you. May the Lord bless you and bless your destiny.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. And amen. Amen. So where is Charles? I thought Charles will present it. Is God? Okay, you guys can present it to them. I don't know. If your people. If you present them, shake their hands. All right, thank you. God bless you all. Okay, amen.